Hi everyone. Today I'm going to start with creating some situation there. Just suppose you are standing on the roof of your house and suddenly you find an aeroplane in the sky. When you look at it, what do you observe? Do you understand what I'm saying you? I am saying you that suppose you are standing on the roof of your house and suddenly you find an aeroplane in the sky. So suppose you are standing on a roof and I'm just taking this is your eye. From here you are going to observe it. This is the position of aeroplane. You are standing on the roof on your house and this, you find an aeroplane in the sky. Then we are going to be meet. Take this point O, then this A, draw from it, draw a vertical line, and from O, horizontal line with the point. So suppose it's meeting a point P there. Now, when you look at it, what do you get here? You get here a right angle triangle there. It's a right angle triangle. You find the aeroplane moving away from you, and after a few seconds, what happened after a few seconds? Just suppose you, the position of aeroplane is what? It's our point A to here. Joining A1, A2 and PQ. Now the our distance from I is what? OA2. If I want to ask you that, can you find out distance between OA2? Or can you tell me the distance between OA? When our aeroplane is moving from A1 to A2, what is the distance between this A1 is to A1, A2 is what given by? Let us consider one of the another situation there, for example. When a person is sitting on a tree at the bank of river, if he observe a bird sitting at the other bank, now can you find the width of the river? If the height at which the person is sitting is known to you, then can you get the width of the river? What all the situation discuss here? In many or more such situations, distance or height can be found by using some mathematical techniques which come under a branch of mathematics. The branch of mathematics is known as what? It's our trigonometry. It is our in the which branch? It's a branch of mathematics known as trigonometry. Trigonometry is a word derived from the three Greek words. It derived from three Greek words. Tri means three. Gon means sides. And third is metron, its meaning measure. Means in the branch of trigonometry, what we are going to do? What we do here? We are going to do the measurement of three sides of triangle there. The trigonometry literally means measurement of sides and angles of a triangle. Originally, it was considered as the branch of mathematics which deals with the sides and the angle of a triangle. But now, trigonometry having a wider scope there. Now, the trigonometry is the study of relationship between the sides and the angles of a triangle. Now, it has its application in astronomy. We have also its application in geography, also in surveying. Also, we have used in engineering and also we use in our navigation. Then this is the application of trigonometry here, but in our point of view in trigonometry, just we are using it's been three measurement of three sides of angle. That's means we are going to deal with here, we are going to deal with here with a triangle, but we are not going to be goes to consider scalene triangle or any type of strain, this we are going to in trigonometry we are going to just use a what? The whole concept was our running about right angle triangle. Our whole trigonometry based about a right angle triangle concept. And what is our right angle triangle? Just suppose we have a right angle triangle ABC, right angle at B, ABC, right angle at B. Now it's right angle at B. B is our 90 degree. Then the side opposite to B is known as, this is our hypotenuse. Just to abbreviate hypotenuse, just we take H. What is the meaning of H? It's H meaning hypotenuse. Now so suppose BC is some tall tree or it's a tower, it's a maybe mountain there. What do we it's and this is the point A is our respective observer there. Then we want to be observed from the point A to the respective in a right angle triangle. Our angle A is an angle C. These both angles are our acute angle. Both are our acute angle. So suppose we are considering here our angle A here. Then with respect to angle A, the side opposite to right angle is hypotenuse. If we are consider angle A, then this side is known as our side adjacent to angle A, and this is our what side opposite to angle A. When we are consider about angle A, our acute angle A, then this is our side adjacent to angle A. This side is when we are discuss with deal with angle A, then our this side is known as base. We take it as B. B means base, and the opposite side with when we are dealing with angle A, take it's our perpendicular. This is our perpendicular. We take its P. We take its P. Now we have a right angle triangle. When we are dealing with our angle acute angle A, then it's this is our perpendicular. This is our base. This is our hypotenuse. Now we now define certain ratios involving the sides of a right triangle. These are called trigonometric ratios. Now we are going to define trigonometric ratios here. Trigonometric ratios. We are discuss what is the trigonometry. It's a measurement of three sides. Then we are here going to be use trigonometric ratios there. Then it means ratios. How many sides we have? We have three sides. When we are going to take in ratios there, then we take this is to this, we get one ratio, and this is to this, we get second ratio, this is to this, we get third ratio, and we also can getting the all ratio, we get the all the converse of all ratio, then we get again three years. Then how many ratios we have? Now we have, there are six trigonometric T ratios, six ratios are there, is known as T ratios, also known as T ratios. We have six T ratios there. What is our six T ratios? I'm just going to explain you. There are our six T ratios. Our now here I am dealing with our acute angle A. Now with respect to angle A, we are going to define our six T ratios. Now our first ratio is sine A. Our first ratio is sine A. It reverses S sine A. Now it's given by what? It defined by perpendicular upon hypotenuse. What is our perpendicular? We are deal with acute angle A. What is our perpendicular? Side opposite to angle A. What is our hypotenuse? It's a side opposite to our right angle. How can we define our sine A? It's a written as sine sin A is given is equal to perpendicular to the hypotenuse. Our second ratio is what? It's a cosine A. It is written as cos A. We can write down as cos A. It defined by base upon hypotenuse. Means the ratio of base to the hypotenuse gives us cosine A. And our third is what? Tangent A, written as tan A, it is given by perpendicular is to base. Now you have to be just learn about three ratios. How can you then other three ratios I am going to define you, how can you learn it? Now first of all, you have to be learn our basics three ratios there: sine, cosine, tangent. Look at perpendicular upon hypotenuse can be written as P hypotenuse as H, base B it's a H, perpendicular P and base H B. Sine A is what? P upon H. Cosine is what? B by H. Tangent is what? P by B. Now how can you learn it? Write down sine, cosine, tangent and then ratio sign there and learn with. First of all, we are going to fill our numerator. P Pakistan, B Bhuka Pyasa, PBP Pakistan, Bhuka Pyasa, H HB Hindustan Hara Bhara. You can learn it by taking numerator Pakistan, Bhuka Pyasa, Pakistan P, भूखा बी, प्यासा पी, हिंदुस्तान एच, हरा हिंदुस्तान हरा भरा. We write down P B P P B P and then H S B, then पाकिस्तान भूखा प्यासा इंसान हर बार. दिस पी बाई एच, दिस आवर पी बाई एच इज वॉट? दिस गिव्स वी साइन. भूखा प्यासा बी बाई एच, दिस गिव्स अस कोसाइन. देन पाकिस्तान भूखा प्यासा, प्यासा भरा, दिस गिव्स आवर पी अपॉन बी इज आवर टेंजेंट. वी गेट आवर टी रेशियो. यू कैन ऑल्सो लर्न इट्स बाई पंडित बद्री प्रसाद हर हर बोले. Can also be learned by formula Pandit Badri Prasad Harar Bole today. Now we have sine, cosine, tangent, P by S, B by S, P by B. Our other T ratios. How can you learn our other T ratios? What I am telling to you, first of all, learn to sine, cosine and tangent. Our sine is given by, our sine is what? We have, it's our perpendicular to the hypotenuse. Our cosine is what? Base to the hypotenuse. Our tangent is what? Perpendicular to the base. Also, we can write down P by H, B by H and P by B. Now other our T ratios are what? This is our first, this is our second, this is our third ratio. Now we have two other three ratios are there. Fourth, our fourth is what? It's a cosecant, cosecant of A. And our fifth is what? It's our known as secant of A, secant A, sec A. And our six is what? It's a cotangent of A. It's our cotangent of A. अब लुक, फर्स्ट आवर इज साइन कोसाइन टेंजेंट, देन वी हैव कोसेकेंट सेकेंट एंड कोटेंजेंट. कोसेकेंट कैन बी रिटन एज इट्स वी एब्रीविएटेड बाय जस्ट वी हैव टेकन साइन साइन ए एज अ साइन ए कोसाइन वी हैव टेक अ कॉस ए एंड टेंजेंट वी टेक अ टेन ए. सिमिलरली आवर कोसेकेंट इज रिटन एज कोसेक ए, आवर सेकेंड ए इज वॉट इट्स सेक ए मीन्स सेकेंड ए. कोटेंजेंट इज रिटन एज cot A. It's our cot A. Cot A means cotangent of A. Now, we have to learn these three only. Then other, this cosecant is what? It's a reciprocal of sine. What is our sine? This is P upon H. Then our cosec is what? This is what? Our H upon P. What I'm telling you? What is our cosec A? Cosec A is our what? It's our sine A. Reciprocal of sine A. Second A is what? It's a reciprocal of cos A. Our cos A is B by S. Then our cosec, our sec A is what? H by B. And last one is cotangent is reciprocal of tangent. Tangent is our P by B. Then here is what? Our B by P. What I'm spelling you? I'm spelling you? It's write down in the relationship between T ratios. What is the relationship between T ratios? What I am explaining you? I am explaining you what is our cosec A. Our cosec is what? Reciprocal of sin A. 1 upon sin A. What I am explaining you? Also I am explaining you our second A. What is our second A? It's a reciprocal of cos A. Third, what is our cotangent of A? It's a reciprocal of 1 by 10 A. These are the three relationship between. What is our relationship? We can also cosec sec cotangent. Then we can also write down what is the multiply of cosec into sin A. And from here we get cosec A into sin A equal to 1. From here what do we get? We can write it, it's a sec A. Sec A into cos A equal to 1. We can write cot as a cot. Cot A into tan A equal to 1. These are the relationship. This is our relationship between T ratios. What is our relationship? Our cosec A into sin A equal to 1, sec A into cos A equal to 1, and cot A into tan A equal to 1. This is our the relationship between T ratios. Now, what we discussed till now, I am discussing with you our trigonometric T ratio till now. What we discuss here? We have discussed here our trigonometry. The whole trigonometry is consists of three words: trigonometron. Tri means three. It makes from three Greek alphabet three Greek words. Trigonometrons. Three gon means sides. Metron means measure. Means it's the whole concept is what about? It's our measurement of sides of triangle. We are just discuss. We are here dealt with our specific. It's about the whole concept is about. It's a right angle triangle. We have a right angle triangle. The side opposite to right angle is known as hypotenuse. What angle we consider? We here deal with angle A. The side opposite to angle A is known as perpendicular. The adjacent side is known as base. Just suppose we are deal with angle C. If we are deal with angle C, then with respect to angle C, look with respect to angle C. Now, this is our hypotenuse, but with respect to angle C, now this is our perpendicular and this is our base. Please remember this and please also listen carefully what I want to say, that when we are going to deal with respect to acute angle A, this is our perpendicular and this is our base. But when we are going to deal with angle C, then with respect to angle C, this side is our perpendicular and this is our base. In trigonometry, we are just dealing with our acute angle. We are going to angle with angle A or angle C. We are not going to be taking any ratios with respect to our 90 degree here. We just are dealing with our with respect to our acute angle there. Now, and after that, I discussed with you 60 ratios. Sin A, cos A, tan A. Sin A is given by P by S, means perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Cosine A is given, cos A given by base upon hypotenuse. Then third one is tangent of A. This is our first. Second, cosine A. Third, tangent of A, tan A, given by perpendicular upon base. Others, then other T ratios is what? Then we have cosecant of A, which is reciprocal of sine A. Since our sine A is P by S, then our cosec is what? H by P. Fifth is our secant of A, written as sec A. Our sec A is reciprocal of cos A. Our cos A is what? It's a B by S. Then it's reciprocal sec given by H by B. And last one, cot, is reciprocal of tangent. Tangent is P by B. For our cotangent, cot is reciprocal of tangent. Then we have B by P. Then we have 6 T ratios. What is our 6 T ratios? P by H, this is our sine by A. B by S, base upon hypotenuse. This is our cos A, perpendicular upon base. P by B, this is our tan A. H by P, this is our hypotenuse upon P, this is our cosec A. H by B, this is our sec A. B by P, this is our cot A. This is our 6 T ratios. What is our 6 T ratios? Sin, cos, tan, cosec, sec, and cot. Then we discuss our relationship between our cosec is reciprocal of sin A, our secant is reciprocal of cos A, and our cotangent is reciprocal of tan A. And the relationship between that, these are cosec A into sin A equal to 1, sec A into cos A equal to 1, cot A into tan A, cot A into tan A equal to 1. Now, we have to be discuss here some remarks. It should be kept in mind because this is you are reading first time. Now, here some remarks you have to be notes here. What you have to remark that first, I am using a sin A. This sin is a one symbol. This is a whole. It's a one symbol, not a sin A. It cannot be sin and A. We cannot separate it. It's not a separate quantity. It is a whole one quantity. It's a sin A. We cannot separate it. The meaning of sin A is not it's a sin into A. We cannot be assume or you cannot be mean that this sin A means it's a sin into A. We can also it's applied to other T ratios. This is a 1. This is our cos A. This is not cos into some A angle there. This is a 1 quantity. This is a 1 symbol only. This is 1 symbol here. We cannot be separated from this cos to the A or A to cos. It's a 1 symbol here, cos A there. And other than that, what the 6 T ratios we are discuss here. Every T ratio is what? Since it's a ratio, then we have a real number. Our every T ratio is a real number. When we are going to be taking squares of it, just suppose also when we are going to further to discuss our trigonometric ratios, then we are using here squares format there, thus meaning we use some terms like a symbol sin square theta, cos square theta, tan square theta. What is this terms? This terms meaning is what? Its meaning is what? It's a sin theta whole square. What is cos square theta? It's a cos theta whole square. It's a tan theta whole square. If we write down sine cube theta, then what is its meaning? Its meaning it's a cube of sine theta. You don't be misguided that what is the meaning of it's a square, x square. It's not sine square theta means it's a whole square of sine theta. Cos square theta means it's a whole square of cos theta. Tan square theta means it's a whole square of tan theta. Sine cube theta means it's a whole cube of sine theta. Also, you have kept in mind that what we discuss here, cosec A, cot A, and sec A. These are the respectively reciprocals of cosec A, cot A, sec A, respectively reciprocals of cosec A is what? Sin A. Then cot A is what? Tan A. And sec A is what? Reciprocal of cos A. Now we have discussed here to getting what we discuss here. We start with our right angle triangle with to our basic concept. We are what we discuss T ratio here. We are taking our A as a acute angle. What we have discussed about T ratios, when A is, we take A is an acute angle. But these ratios, what is the value of A? This is true for any value of A. This ratios are true for any value of A. But in the respective of you, what you are learn about at the level of class 10th, we are just discuss here with the acute angles only. Our all T ratios for here, acute angles. And look, in triangle, what we measure here, in the basic concept, what is your angle concept? There are two types of angles in your basics. It's a positive angle. Just suppose we have a measuring angle, then it's our positive angle. What we deal here, it's a whole concept is about our all acute angles are positive. What is negative angle? If it is our, this is our initial side and this is our terminal side, then this angle is known as, it's our negative angle there. When this is our initial and this is our terminal, what do you mean? When we are going to measure angle about which direction is this? In anti-clockwise direction, then our angle is measured. If we are moving with in a clockwise direction, then our angle is what? It's a negative angle there. Means our angle, it depends on rotation of ray. If our rotation is anti-clockwise direction, in anti-clockwise, then what we have? In anti-clockwise, our angle is considered as a positive angle. In a clockwise direction, we measure it's a in negative angle there. Then these are the remarks. What do you have to be kept in mind that till now? What do we discuss here? We have discussed some remarks there. What is the remarks? This sine A is only one symbol there. We cannot separate it. Our T ratios are real numbers. We cannot take here imaginary numbers there. And sine square, cos square, theta can be written as sine theta whole square and cos theta whole square. Then sine theta is what given by whole cube. Then cos A, K, cot A and sec A is the our reciprocal of sine A, tan A and cos A. You have to be learned then now for today. You have to be learned this T ratio. Then we are going to be tomorrow we are going to start with some problems with our T based on T ratios and further concept there. For today, you have to be learned our 60 ratios. Sin A is what? Sin A is given by P upon S. Cos A was B by S. And our tan A was P by B. Cosec H upon P. Sec A is H by B. And our cot A is B by P. You have to be today learned these are 60 ratios. Then in In our next class, we are going to discuss this best problem on our this T ratios.